We've heard a lot in recent months about COVID-19 vaccine passports, but John Sanders is focusing on problems linked to those passports, especially in light of natural immunity. John is the Senior Fellow in Regulatory Studies and Research Editor at the John Locke Foundation. He wrote about this issue recently for the American Institute for Economic Research. John, you start this piece by mentioning that there is a growing body of research showing just how valuable natural immunity is.
Yes, many studies have come out proving what, but it's what we've always known about viruses, that natural immunity is strong and durable. Vaccines are also very important, but the reason vaccination came about in the first place is because we noticed people who've had this virus, be it chickenpox or smallpox or whatever, they don't get sick again. But it's a very high price to pay for not getting sick again. So vaccines would give you a lower dose so that your body can defeat it, and then you've got the immunity. But we've always known that natural immunity was strong.
There's been a very strong push for as many people as possible to get vaccines. But one of the things that your piece points out is that for people who have been infected, this natural immunity that may be so good for them can be hurt by a vaccine.
Yeah, some of the research is indicating that there could be some negative side effects for people who already have natural immunity from a prior COVID-19 infection. So in the equation for them is pretty much all cost and no benefit.
In fact, you mentioned one particular scholar who made this case to his boss that, look, I had COVID-19. Here are the facts that suggest I should not get a vaccine.
Yes, George Mason Law Professor Todd Zawitzki, who won a case, really forced the university to back down from forcing him into a vaccine that he argued that he didn't need because he already has natural immunity. He brought all these studies up at the time. I mean, there's more now, saying that, you know, what he has is already better, or at least as strong as vaccine-induced immunity. And he has concerns about contraindications. And for his case, it was shingles.
And another thing that you point out here is that as all of this information about natural immunity has come out, the growing body of research, there's this continuing push for vaccine passports, basically ensuring that people who want to do some normal daily life functions have had the vaccine. And you say this information about natural immunity really counters or thwarts any case for the passports.
Yes, for two reasons. I mean, one, I mean, the underlying social call for the vaccine passports is supposedly to produce this herd immunity. But it's overlooking how many people already have natural immunity. And two, I went through the math on this. And, you know, since I wrote the piece, which is over a week ago, that I wrote it. It was published just a few days ago. But since I wrote it, the math is now that over half of Americans have natural immunity. Based on case numbers, it's like as of now, just checked, it's almost 40.9 million cases. The CDC estimates that of every case, there's 4.2 infections. Which makes sense if you think about it. I mean, not everybody's rushing out and getting tested. A lot of people are asymptomatic or have mild colds. They're not going to go to the doctor for that. If there's one case in a household of four and everybody gets sick, everybody knows why they're sick. And that was the case for me. So if you multiply 4.2 times the 40.87 million as of today, and then you subtract out the 653,000, I think, deaths, you get over 171 million Americans with prior infections, which is well over half the population. So it's a coin flip for any person you see whether or not they have natural immunity.
One thing that you address is this concern among those who are pushing for the passports that, oh, how do we know that people have natural immunity? Whereas if they have the passport, we know they've had the vaccine. You say that this is not a great argument in their favor.
No, because like I said, it's a coin flip between any person that you see, whether or not they already have immunity. And the natural immunity is much stronger than the vaccine-based immunity. The new research out of Israel, just published in August, showed that, and looking at 32,000 people, showed that people with vaccine-based immunity were 6 to 13 times more likely to have a breakthrough infection, to get sick with COVID, than were people who have prior immunity from a prior infection were to get reinfected. And then when they adjusted for comorbidities, they found that this likelihood was 27 times more likely. That's not to say don't get a vaccine. It's just to say don't overlook people with natural immunity. They have the stronger immunity. They serve the state's interest even better than those with vaccine-based immunity.
I'd like to focus on one of the final statements in your column at the American Institute for Economic Research, and that is the right response in these uncertain times is, as always, the response that protects people's liberty and respects their autonomy.
Absolutely. The natural immune have rights. They certainly should not have their rights of movement, of everything that they enjoyed as a matter of course prior to March 2020, be taken away from them just because they haven't taken a vaccine that they don't even need. And furthermore, we don't know who those people are, and we shouldn't presume to judge.
And that is a case against vaccine passports. If you'd like to learn much more, you can go to the American Institute for Economic Research's website and find the column with the headline, Stronger, More Robust Natural Immunity Thwarts Any Case for Vaccine Passports. The author, John Sanders of the John Locke Foundation, also writes about it at the Locker Room blog. Thanks so much, John.
Thanks, Mitch.